Hey guys, Real Underground Club King here. Welcome back to the channel. We are now at vlog number 5. And this is a really, really interesting story on how I almost ended up hiring and going into business with the Preppy Killer. The Preppy Killer was a guy by the name of Robert Chambers. And he murdered a girl in Central Park, probably in the late 90s. And it was a very, very, very high publicized story. He strangled her. It had to do with S&M and nightclubs and this and that. And he made a joke about it on television. He went on, I think, Entertainment Tonight and snapped the doll's head off while he was out on bail, making a mockery of the whole thing. And they called her the Preppy Killer because the guy looked like a preppy. Very handsome, tall guy. Looked like a college, you know, really handsome college guy. And he ended up getting convicted, doing time, getting out. And that's where the story kind of begins. After I finished with the vault, my business partner and best friend, Kenny Lee, opened up a club in Soho. It was called Big Six. It was right on the corner of Grand and Hester Street. It was like a lounge, sort of a club lounge. It was going pretty good. We had the whole second floor. Things were going well. So I needed an assistant. So I put an ad in, I think it was the Village Voice or online, whatever, for an assistant. And I was interviewing people. All of a sudden, this girl walks in, Sean Koval. Blonde girl, kind of looked like a biker sort of a girl. And I'm talking to her, telling her about the club, telling her about the vault. At that time, I was beginning to work on the book, what was going on. And she goes, yeah, I saw an article in the paper that you were interested in working on stories in the vault. And you had mentioned the guy by the name of Robert Chambers. I said, yeah, Robert Chambers, the Preppy Killer. So she goes, that's my boyfriend. I said, come on, he's not your boyfriend. She goes, he's my boyfriend. I said, I'd love to meet the guy and interview him for the book, this and that. She goes, you want to meet me? He's in the car. I thought she was totally pulling my leg. I thought she was going to bring in somebody, I don't know, maybe try to pull some type of scam or something. She goes out to the car, and in comes Robert Chambers, the Preppy Killer. I'm like, oh my God, this is fucking unbelievable. So we had a conversation. You could tell that him and her, they were still all drugged out. You know, she was twitching like a meth nut, and he was just all sweaty and everything. It's just a weird couple. Anyway, to make a long story short, I take them up to the lounge, and we have a conversation. I tell her I'm looking for an assistant. He's trying to find a job. He's trying to get work. For the next 2 or 3 days, the Preppy Killer and his girlfriend start coming, hanging around Big Stick Lounge. And they're buying us Chinese food. We're hanging out with them, and he's telling us all these stories. And I'm like, this is completely surreal. And he was looking to make some money off the books. So I said, maybe you could do security. Maybe you could do something here, because they had sued him. I guess the girl that he was responsible, whose death he was responsible for, the family sued him. And they had like a $20 million judgment against him. So he couldn't work. Anything that he made by, you know, by an actual job on the books, they were going to snatch it for the lawsuit. So I said, maybe we could do something, this and that. So I was throwing around an idea one night. All of us are sitting there. He's there with his girlfriend. They're drinking. They're a little buzzed. I said, listen, what about a charity poker game of all criminals? But hold on, hold on. Before you guys out there and everybody starts laughing about this, people that have committed heinous crimes, especially in New York, let's do a charity poker game, maybe in Vegas, Atlantic City, and give the money to the victims. Robert Chambers, a preppy murderer. He murdered a girl. We do that. We do it to murder victims. Joel Rifkin was a serial rapist. We could get him, you know, do it for victims of rape. Mike Tyson at that time was hanging a lot around in New York. He had been convicted of rape. I'm sure he wouldn't want to get involved and give it to victims in that. So, you know, the whole idea is to raise money for charity, raise money for ourselves. You're seeing victims gain from the people that had accused crimes against them, and people sort of repenting for their sins. It was just, you know, bullshit night talk at 3 o'clock in the morning. I didn't think it was going to go anywhere. All of a sudden, this guy goes to the newspapers and said that, you know, Anthony Marini, the club guy, is just starting a poker tournament of murderers in Vegas. Blah, blah, blah. I'm getting calls from the press, calls from the papers. And then they said, all right, I said, well, that's the story. So they did a, the New York Post and the Daily News came and did a story with pictures about it. And it was probably one of the fucking stupidest things I've ever thought up in my whole entire life. But I did get a lot of press, a lot of attention that was meant with good intentions. And then I said, okay, let's try to plan it. Shortly after that, Robert Chambers disappears. I can't find him. He was living in a rent-controlled apartment on 57th Street with his girlfriend. I knew the address. Their phones have been disconnected, this and I don't know what's going on. 2 days later, I'm eating dinner. I turn on the nightly news. He's all over the news. It turns out him and the girlfriend were dealing large amounts of coke and meth and everything out of their apartment while he was on parole. It was a sting operation. They got arrested. She flipped on him. He's doing 20 years and they're gone. And I was like, oh my God, please, never again, never again. But it was a really interesting story. I mean, to get to, you write about things in the book. Usually in my book, if you read all the stories in the book, by the way, the book The Vault by Anthony Marini, published by Book Baby, will be out in stores and online 10/16. Don't forget it, 10/16, The Vault. And anyway, you write about things, some you've experienced, some is hearsay, you're researching stuff. But somebody who was such a staple, like in American Crime in New York, I got to actually have a conversation with him. And, you know, it was kind of cool, but we could have did without the poker game. But anyway, I want to thank you guys for supporting this channel. Thank you guys for supporting my Instagram. My Instagram is nightlife_mogul. And there's a lot of great stories coming out. Please buy the book, subsequent film after that. You know, comment down below, click in the description box, subscribe. Thanks a lot, guys. We'll see you on the next one.